So, I know you mentioned that you were actually really good in Tamil, and at a point in time you kind of like lost touch. So, what kind of advice would you give to young people about staying connected or staying in touch with the language?
I think it's important. You know, you could watch films, you could listen to songs. You could also read. So there are many options, and whichever that, that you feel good doing, you know, whichever that gives you the pleasure, activates the pleasure senses, and you could do that. So when it comes to, you know, some people like to like watch a film that could be the easiest way to learn something. It's extremely important to also conversate. You know, that's when you get like a holistic education, and you can also continue to improve yourself because you get to apply whatever that you're learning. And in order to do that, it's also important to make conversations, you know, and there are plenty of people around to make conversations. And you will only know how good it feels to express in your mother tongue if you try. And it usually feels very different compared to expressing it in English. Of course, there are many, many beautiful thoughts that you can express in English. When you learn how to express in your own mother tongue, for me it's Tamil, there are some words which are irreplaceable, which they do not exist in English vocabulary. So these kind of things, you will only get exposed to it if you really know the language.
And because you were mentioning you had two kids, right? So how do you try to get them exposed to, you know, the mother tongue?
Because you see, for me, in my case, right, there's one poem which I keep reciting whenever I feel like, you know, I need strength, whenever life gets tough, and that poem is in Tamil. And I always tell them that, you know, the thing that could save your life, the thing that could keep you alive, the thing that could make you thrive, it could be in that language actually. So don't leave it out, you know, because there's a lot, because with language comes literature, culture, heritage, tradition, art, history. There are many things which are related to a certain language, and we are missing out on everything if we leave that language out. So we are blessed in Singapore to learn one more language. It's mandatory. So we shouldn't put that in waste, and I think we should make the effort to learn that language.
Okay, and what kind of advice would you give your 15-year-old self?
With my kids, I actually try to do, watch films with them, and I write songs, and I ask them, do you know the meaning of these lyrics? And I encourage them to write in Tamil as well. So when I turn back and look at it, you know, it was a very organic process for us, because mum was speaking in Tamil and we all spoke in Tamil. We also spoke Malay at home, we spoke English at home, so we spoke like three languages at home. These days, you know, it's very difficult for people to learn, like, you know, even one language proper. You know, it's become like such a huge task to learn another language. But it need not be. I think it's very psychological in that sense. When I turn back, look at myself, my 15-year-old self, I think the only thing I would have told myself is I should have dug deeper, you know, into like the literary components of the language. Because today it could have helped me even more with my lyric writing and my songwriting. So that is one thing which I would have told myself, that okay, you know, don't stop on surface level just by speaking and writing and reading. You know, dig deeper, because there's so much buried into the language.
Okay, sure. Thank you so much.